A resilient New York has to be defined resilient over which periods of time. And if we make it resilient today in an almost perfect sense that we had no financial constraints and what we would do now, we would probably create a New York that would be disastrously non-resilient in the year 2200. So my fundamental criticism is not what they propose for now in the near future. What I am very concerned with is that if we make ourselves resilient for the short run, we will create almost impossible situations for future generations. When people hear the word retreat, then they think it's the demise. We should look at it as opportunities for creating new and sustainable communities. And with respect to waterfront and proximity to the ocean and estuarine tidal waters, to live in lowlands in a large scale is unsustainable. Locally, in a limited way, and for modest, medium, 50, 100, maybe 150 years, that's possible. But as a basic sustainability principle, we should take note that New York City and some other coastal areas not too far from it have the luxury of higher topography. We need this high topography looked at as an asset that we have to cherish and gradually and very, very sensibly develop, but not handing it over to developers in the traditional sense, but as a society come to grips how to interchange the lowlands that we all were focused on in the last 400 years and really think about the next 400 years, how we make this transition. So retreat is, I think, a bad word for an opportunity for future transitions. And that's what I have in mind. We have to get away from the concept, oh, we have to give something up. We give something back. We don't give it up. We want to take care of ourselves, and that's not a good place to take care of yourself in the lowlands. I don't want anybody today to be the decision maker for future generations. I want them to make their decisions without the burden from our follies. That's the only thing I'm saying. I'm not making any projections what New York City will look like in 50, 100, or 200 years. But I don't want to create solutions now that I definitely know will not survive for those time horizons. That's all I'm saying. Future generations will have to deal with their own problems, but we should not create liabilities now for them. We have bridges and subway systems that are 100 years old. we shouldn't create anything now that in 100 years is a new liability. So, the principle is that we have to have a long-term view to create meaningful short-term solutions.